To help keep kids safe and cool this summer, Boston Centers for Youth and Families offers a wide range of affordable and fun programs. There's everything from neighborhood block parties to girls' night and a camp specifically tailored towards residents with special needs. Chris Beiner, Interim Executive Director at BCYF, joins us now to help parents and kids sift through all of these exciting options. Chris, thanks a lot for being with us.
Thanks, Adam, for having us.
So as we were talking about earlier, this is kind of peak season for you guys. And I know summer, all these pools and community centers kind of magically appear. But tell us about the work that goes into it, even as far back as wintertime.
Sure. You know, a lot of people don't realize Boston Centers Youth and Families actually provides programs, quality opportunities year round. We have a network of 35 community centers, facilities, 29 community centers spread out throughout the city of Boston to really provide a myriad of programs and opportunities for children, youth, and families holistically. So our framework is ACEs, arts, civic engagement, education, sports, and fitness. And, you know, we're clearly trying to be the places where families know that they can come in and get their needs met year round, 12 months out of the year.
Right, right. So what kind of keeps you going? What keeps you motivated? Because I know the first time I came across your name and face was as a street worker here in the city, and you've been doing it for a number of years. Why is all this so important?
Well, first of all, you know, I'm a lifelong resident of this city, so I love Boston. You know, it's a great opportunity that the mayor has afforded me to be in the position that I am today. So, you know, one thing that keeps me going is knowing that a lot of the children, youth, and families who walk through our doors are similar to me. A young person growing up in the city of Boston who was just looking for some positive programming and opportunities. So, You know, there's nothing more that keeps me going than seeing people smile.
Yeah. Now, you say you grow up here. Has being a kid changed at all? Is it different now from back when you were a kid?
You know, yeah, it is. And it seems like, you know, things are a little bit more fast-paced, You know, and it seems like the ramifications seem to have much greater emphasis. You know, things that we used to get away with and move on, kids nowadays don't seem to be able to, you know, they seem to follow them, you know, so right. It is a different time. But at the end of the day, youth development is youth development. And then really, you know, whether it was kids when, you know, I'm my age myself, You know, 30 years ago right. Or now, you know, kids are kids and really trying to make sure that we're providing some opportunities for them to be able to be autonomous as they are.
Yeah. Well, let's talk about some of the programs you guys have to help enable kids do that and kind of stay on the right track. I mean, I think the core of the summer menu for kids would be some of the day camps.
Sure.
Can you talk just generally about what happens at these camps and Who they're tailored for?
Sure. So most of the camps that we operate, and we have a camp at pretty much every one of our community centers across the city, are geared towards youth, 6 to 12, 6 to 13 years of age. And, you know, obviously parents have to work, kids are out of school, so we try to make sure that when they're in our facilities, they're having a fun-filled day of activity. So they're doing workshops and enrichment programs, they're doing camps. You know, this is a great time for kids at, like, for me, you know, there's a great place out right outside of well, it's in Boston, but the Harbors.
Right.
Kids, you know, grow up in the city, we're the capital of the Bay State, and they don't get a chance to
sure, it's like
enjoy,
a different world.
Right, to enjoy the Harbors. So we do things like that where we're getting kids out and getting them to explore the city.
Can you talk about swimming specifically? Because to be honest, I hated camp when I was a kid. And part of it was I didn't know how to swim. You know, I didn't have friends that had outdoor pools, that kind of thing. So the first time I saw a pool and there was pressure to like jump in, it was a little, you know. So talk about what you guys can do to help bridge that gap.
Well, I'm glad you asked me about the aquatics program at BCYF because, you know, we have 17 pools and one beach, and we just opened M Street Beach at the BCYF Curly over in South Boston. You know, it is a great opportunity to get young people. I mean, I get excited when I start talking about our aquatics program, one, because there's so many young people who actually take advantage of it. And, you know, it's important that, you know, you just shared, so I'm going to share.
Sure.
You know, I can't swim either. You know,
and
I just really started to learn how to swim.
Oh, good for you.
And it's important not only that we provide every kid in the city an opportunity to learn how to swim, but also the adults. And so, you know, we're doing the Learn to Swim for the summer. You know, obviously kids get hot, they want to go into the pool to cool off. But we also want to make sure that they're able to swim. And we have a swim league where we have probably, I don't know, 14, 15 of our pools where we have teams in the swim league. 300 program participants.
Wow.
You know, it's just phenomenal, and I think it's an opportunity for us to really grow.
Yeah. There seems to be also more of a focus this year on teens in general. And specifically, I know today is July 6th, kind of the kickoff day for the Super Teens program.
Yes.
That Mayor Walsh introduced, I guess, a couple months back.
Yes.
Now. But talk about this age group and the folks at Super Teens, what they'll be doing, why that age group is important, that kind of thing.
You know, our Super Teens, our youth, they're 13 to 14-year-olds. And, you know, 13 and 14-year-olds, as I just said, our summer camps oftentimes up to 12, 13. So our 13 and 14-year-olds, sometimes they get left out. They're too old for the summer day camps. They're a little bit too young to work.
Right.
And so this is sort of an opportunity for them to have something specifically geared towards them. And really, it's a pre-employment opportunity. So for many of them, it's their first, you know, foray into the employment world. And
right.
So they learn a little bit about employment. They do some workshops. But it's also an opportunity to continue to have fun. Because as a 13 and 14-year-old, you know, hey, what's summer like without having some fun?
Right. Can't all and be work.
No.
Right.
So we want to make sure that, you know, it's a not only a fruitful experience for the 13 and 14-year-olds in terms of learning what employment looks like,
mm-hmm.
but also they're learning, you know, about the city. They're having some fun times. And so, you know, the day is really consists of some fun and some pre-employment workshops and things of that nature.
Right. Right. Tell us a little bit about Camp Joy. I know it's been in the city for quite a long time, but for our viewers who may not be familiar with it, this is a program that specifically reaches out to children and adults, sounds like, ages 3 to 22 of special needs.
Yep.
So, you know, what's your sense of what they're accomplishing over there?
I'll tell you something. You know, they do an amazing job with Camp Joy. And, you know, I just really believe that we should be providing opportunities for any and everybody. And, you know, there's a certain population sometimes, and, you know, they have some disabilities, whether they're mental, physical, and or psychosocial, where we have to also make sure that they're getting the same opportunities that kids who don't have those disabilities. And we do that. You know, we do it day in and day out. And I love going out and seeing the young people smile mm-hmm. and have fun.
Have you heard anything back from the parents of these kids and what it means to them as a family so their sons or daughters have this kind of opportunity?
We do. And, you know, one, the families try to, you know, they're kicking our doors to try to be a part of Camp Joy. But, you know, they tell us all the time how important it is for the kids to be able to be engaged in a positive way, in a fun way.
Yeah. How about Girls Night? Tell us a little bit about Girls Night.
You know, Girls Nights, I'll tell you, you know, Girls Nights for me, you know, I'm from a big family. I have a lot of sisters. And of course, I have a mother and lots of loving aunts and so on and so forth. We have to provide some specific programs for girls, and our Girls' Nights Out are a great opportunity to do so. You know, getting young women in the room and getting them to learn from each other, get to know each other, to get to talk to different mentors, get to have some fun. You know, I think it's a great thing for the city. And, you know, unfortunately, you know, over the last couple of years, girls are becoming what we call collateral damage to violence. And so we have to make sure that girls understand the implications of relationships they're getting involved in. And so we have those conversations. And, you know, our Girls' Nights Out are a lot of fun.
Yeah. Speaking of fun, how about these block parties that I see haven't started yet but are going to start soon, July 9th? And we should say, we'll put it on the screen, but for people who are watching and want more information, the best place to go is probably the website.
Yeah, it's boston.gov, BCYF/BCYF, or you can follow us on Twitter at BCYF Centers.
Mm-hmm.
So,
Block parties, July 9th.
July 9th is the kickoff over in Clardy Pool in Childstown. Mm-hmm. Block parties are a lot of fun.
Sure.
They're a lot of fun because not only is it about the family, it's the entire family gets to come out and really, you know, just have fun, get to have a hot dog, a healthy meal, you know, see a lot of the things that are taking place, not only at our community centers, but also a lot of the agencies and organizations that are operating in and around, not only that neighborhood, but the entire city, it's just music, you know, some fun activities, lots of information. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a good day. If you're available, you should come out, and I definitely encourage everyone else to come out and take part in it.
Yeah, it sounds like a great chance for maybe a parent who says, oh, well, man, it's already July. I didn't sign my kid up for camp. Or it sounds like just a great place for the parents and families to come and meet people at BCYF and other organizations.
Yes.
As a breaking off point, so then they can say, you know what, we have swimming lessons that happen.
Yep.
Next week. Or so it might be their first experience to get involved with BCYF.
Yep.
but a fun first experience.
Yep.
To kind of make that.
Yep.
Meeting point happen.
Yep, that's exactly it, Adam. I mean, clearly we want anyone to come out, so whether you're old or a new member, we want you to come out and enjoy it. But really it is to sort of make sure that the folks who aren't aware of what takes place at BCYF, you know, that they can get an opportunity to come in and learn about us. And experience us. You know, we'll have the pool there so you can swim. You know, we'll probably have some cotton candy there so you can have some cotton candy.
Sure.
We'll have some fun there, face painting. It'll be a lot of fun.
Great. Well, we thank you so much for coming by today. And we'll mention again for parents who need more information, the best place is boston.gov/BCYF.
/BCYF, yes. And you can also follow us at BCYF Centers. Thanks, Adam, for having us. And, you know, we're grateful of the opportunity to come out today.
Oh, we appreciate it. We'll have you back next summer. Maybe by that point, we'll both know how to swim.
We'll hold you to that,
all right? All right. Thanks
you
a lot,
hold me
Chris.
To it, too.
Thanks a lot, Chris.
Thank you.